Hey guys, it's Cap, and I'm here with Richard Iggo from Telltale Games. And he just showed us a demo of the first 20 minutes or so of The Walking Dead Episode 2.
Yeah.
Now, in this we saw repercussions of a certain way of playing through the first episode. So, wow, how different is this from what else could have happened?
Well, I mean, some of the sort of like high points that are pretty obvious is the fact that in this version that we showed you today, we decide in episode one to save Doug. So Carly's dead, she's gone. But you know, Doug brings things to the table that Carly probably wouldn't have done, and you saw that again in this demo. I don't want to like talk about it too much to spoil things, but so they're like the big beats, you see that kind of stuff. But there's also the relationship that you have with Kenny and his family. This playthrough is based on us really trying to maintain and grow that relationship. So consequently, the relationship with Lily and her father Larry has really suffered. And that's definitely something that moves through this entire episode.
How do you feel about taking this this franchise and doing with it what in a lot of ways, a lot of people feel that the television show hasn't really succeeded at? And for starters, there's a lot of violence in it, but the violence is earned via the way it plays out in the story and all the ways the characters behave with each other. It's a rich experience.
Yeah, the violence in this game is, you know, there are many games out there that have a level of gore and violence that are on the same level as this game. But some friends and I had a conversation about this yesterday, having seen some of the other games at the show and the demos that they have. In those games, you want to be performing and carrying out that violence. It's part of, you know, your character. You know, you're smashing somebody in the face with a shotgun and stuff like that, and you want to do that. You absolutely have to do that. In The Walking Dead, A, you're given a choice. Do I do this right now? Do I hurt this person? Do I, you know, we've just seen that in the demo. And then more importantly than that, generally speaking, most people are not going to want to do the thing that we force them into doing. So it's a very different experience of violence. A lot of people, I think that they're desensitized to violence in video games. You know, you can go out there and play whatever M-rated first-person shooter and see tons of violence and legs and arms coming off all over the place, but you're almost expecting it. Whereas in The Walking Dead, even though you are expecting it, you don't want it to happen, and you try to push yourself as far away from what you're seeing on screen at that point because it truly is horrific, and that's, you know, obviously really important to a game based on The Walking Dead.
When you guys are designing this and laying out the story, do you have sort of an active timeline? For example, this episode 2 takes place 3 months after the end of the prior episode.
Right.
So I assume you might be gauging, all right, well, what was happening spatially with, because obviously they're somewhere near Herschel's farm, so
right.
Say like with Rick's story and everything, and where does this fit on this plot of world-changing items?
Well, right at the outset of episode 2, it's 3 months after the very end of episode 1. And if you've played episode 1, you saw basically our heroes, as it were, they'd found that motor in. They decided that was a good place to basically create a base. And right at the end of episode 2, you come right back to them having been there for 3 months. But the big deal is, of course, that as time has passed, they've gone from being right at the beginning of the zombie apocalypse, where there was still electricity at the outset. There was still, from the sounds that you heard, you know, you could hear gunfire in the distance and stuff like that. It sounded like government forces of some kind were trying to put up a resistance to the walkers. But that's all gone now. You're in the deep midwinter of Zombieville right now. So there's no electricity. There's nobody there to look after you. There's no government structure. And the big deal is that there's no food. So, you know, that's the number one priority of the people in this episode. They've got to find food. And obviously, that in and of itself is quite a stressful thing, but that also creates these new stressful situations between you and the other survivors in your group. So you now have to manage all these dynamics of no food and, you know, what are these other people thinking right now? How do I deal with that situation?
I'm really excited for the game coming to the console. I'm wondering, when it goes on Xbox Live, will it still have the same sort of purchasing options, like getting it all at once and downloading every time you get a subsequent title comes out?
For Xbox Live, it's basically treated as DLC, so you're able to buy each episode from within the episode 1 wrapper, as it were. The other platforms, they offer the same system, except for, so with PlayStation Network, you can go on there and buy individual episodes, or you can actually buy a season pass. So as soon as a new episode's available, the new episode's available to you. And the same sort of situation applies to PC and Mac, which you can buy either from our Telltale store or from Steam, and you can just buy the entire season.
Very cool. So look forward to Walking Dead Part 2 coming out very soon, and look forward to Walking Dead the series coming out on your favorite system in their home console. And maybe also look forward to a game based on Fables, but he didn't say that, I did. Anyway, I'm Cap with Nerdy Show and Bleeding Cool. You can check out all of our E3 coverage at nerdyshow.com/E3 2012 at nerdyshowandbleedingcool.com.